दिस इज द वीडियो फॉर क्लास 8 साइंस चैप्टर 5 पार्ट 3। सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू। वाइल्ड लाइफ इज अ वैल्यूएबल बायोलॉजिकल रिसोर्स। इज द वेरियस फैक्टर्स रिस्पॉन्सिबल ऑफ वाइल्ड लाइफ डिस्ट्रक्शन एंड डिप्लीटेशन आर हैबिटेट लॉस, इंडिस्क्रिमिनेट हंटिंग, पॉल्यूशन। हैबिटेट लॉस क्या होता है? द डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ नेचुरल हैबिटेट ऑफ एनिमल्स बाय डिफॉरेस्टेशन डिस्टर्ब्स द लाइफ ग्रोथ एंड रिप्रोड्यूसिंग टाइम ऑफ वाइल्ड एनिमल्स। इंडिस्क्रिमिनेट हंटिंग, इंडिस्क्रिमिनेट किलिंग एंड पोचिंग ऑफ वाइल्ड एनिमल्स फॉर स्किन, फूड, फर, हॉर, टस्क एक्सेट्रा। पॉल्यूशन, एयर, वाटर एंड सॉइल पॉल्यूशन इज ऑल्सो रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर डेथ एंड एलिमिनेशन ऑफ सेंसिटिव वाइल्ड स्पीशीज। देयर आर मैनी गवर्नमेंटल एंड नॉन गवर्नमेंटल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वर्किंग टू प्रोटेक्ट, प्रिजर्व एंड कंजर्व द एनवायरमेंट। रेड डाटा बुक, द IUCN इंटरनेशनल यूनियन ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ नेचुरल एंड नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज मेंटेन अ इंटरनेशनल लिस्ट ऑफ पब्लिश एज अ रेड डाटा बुक। इट इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड साइंटिफिक एक्सपर्ट दैट वर्क फॉर द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ सस्टेनेबल लिविंग रिसोर्सेज। इट इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी द बेस्ट अथॉरिटी अबाउट द स्टेटस ऑफ लिविंग थिंग्स ऑन द प्लैनेट। The Red Data Book is the state document established for documenting rare and endangered species of plants and animals that exist within the territories of the state or country. This book provides central information for studies and monitoring programs on rare and endangered species and their habitats. The IUCN has developed categories for describing threatened species. Threatened is the term used for species that are in the critical endangered and endangered and vulnerable category below. EX, a group of extinct when there are no reasonable doubt that the last individual has died, like dinosaur, became extinct as they could not adapt to climate change. Extinct क्या होता है? जो खत्म ही है, बिल्कुल है भाई नहीं, जैसे dinosaur. Extinct in the wild, a group is extinct in the wild when it is only to survive in cultivation and in captivity or as a naturalized population or populations well outside the past range. A group is presumed extinct in the wild when exhaustive surveys is known and expect habitat at appropriate time and throughout its historic range have failed to record an individual, survey should be over a time frame appropriate to the animal's life cycle and life form. A group is critically endangered when it is facing an extremely high risk of extinction in the wild immediate future. A group is endangered when it is not critically endangered but is facing a very high risk of extinction in the wild in the near future. Examples of endangered animals are Indian rhinoceros, Asiatics, lions, crocodiles and blue whales. Vulnerables, a group of vulnerable when it is not critically endangered or endangered by facing a high risk of extinction in the wildlife in the medium term future. Chikara deer, black buck, golden langur are example of vulnerable species. A group of low risk when it is evaluated and doesn't satisfy the criteria for any of the categories, critically endangered or vulnerable, the group includes in the lower risk category. Can be separated into three subcategories: CD, conservation dependent, near threatened, least concerned. A group is data deficient when there is an inadequate information to make direct or indirect assumption of its risk of extinction based on its distribution or population status. A group in this category may be well studied or it's biologically well known, but appropriate data and abundance or distribution is lagged, data deficient is therefore not a category of threat or lower risk. A group of non-evaluated when it has yet been assessed against the criteria. Protected areas are undisturbed habitats for wildlife. These include national park, sanctuaries and biosphere reserves. A national park is a protected land area preserved in natural condition to provide natural habitat to wildlife, forest grazeries, cultivation and free entry of the people not allowed in the National Park. Jim Crowfoot Park in Uttarakhand was the first national park established in India in 1936 CE. As of 2015, there are 102 national parks in India. Wildlife sanctuaries. A sanctuary is a protected land area reserved for the conservation of wild animals, birds, and plants. Hunting is strictly prohibited there. However, private ownership rights of collecting minor forest products, harvesting of timber, and cultivation are granted. So long as they do not interfere with life of wild animals in India, there are 515 wildlife sanctuaries. Biosphere reserves. A biosphere reserve is a specified land area in which multiple use of land permitted for preserving biodiversity. It is divided into three zones for different activities. Core zone, where no human activity is permitted, where limited human activity is permitted, where several human activities are permitted. There are 243 biosphere reserves in the world, including 14 in India. Our biosphere reserves help maintaining the biodiversity as well as the culture of the area. A biosphere reserve may also contain other protected areas like national parks and wildlife sanctuaries. For example, Pachmari Biosphere Reserve includes Satpura National Park and two wildlife sanctuaries, Bori and Pachmari. Hunting regulations. Strict laws are needed to regulate hunting or poaching of animals. All countries have the law to protect and safeguard the environment. Our government has made the following laws. The Environment Protection Law in 1986, the Forest Conservation Act in 1980, and the Wildlife Protection Act in 1972. Strict laws have been implemented to regulate hunting of animals that are endangered. The hunting of the tiger is banned in India since 1973. Elephants and rhinoceros are killed for ivory and horns. Ivory matlab unke daant. Bears and fox for furs, tiger for skin. Thought the trading of ivory for skin are banned in, but poaching will still go on as the buyer are ready to buy. Proper management should be developed for preservation of animals as well as controlled killing of endangered species. Breeding wild animals in captive has saved some endangered species from extinction, such as musk deer in Garhwal Hills, tigers in Gir Forest, and Girihali in Nandankan Zoological Park in Odisha. Government of India has started some breeding projects to save endangered species. Some of them are Project Tiger, Gir Lion Project, Crocodile Breeding Project, Himalayan Musk Deer Project, Rhino Conservation Project, etc. Project Tiger was launched in 1973 in CE. Save Tiger from Poaching. Under the project, 48 Tiger Reserve has been established in India. 48 Tiger Reserve banaye gaye the India mein. Gir Lion Project hai aapka. The project was started by the government of Gujarat in 1972 CE to protect Asiatic lions ko bachane ke liye. Migration kya hota hai bachcho? माइग्रेशन इज अ रेगुलर पीरियोडिक टू वे मूवमेंट ऑफ बर्ड्स एंड सम एनिमल्स फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर रेजिडेंट टू सम अदर प्लेस अलॉन्ग वेल डिफाइंड रूट. माइग्रेशन इज लिंक टू द सीजनल फैक्टर ऑफ ब्रीडिंग शॉर्टेज ऑफ फूड. बर्ड माइग्रेट टू प्लेस वेयर द क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन आर सूटेबल. दे ले एग्स. When the eggs are hatched and the chicks are capable of flying, they move back to their natural habitat. Climatic conditions have become suitable. These birds are called migratory birds. Birds like crane, grebe, pelicans come to India during the winters and rainy seasons. The Bharatpura Bird Sanctuary is known for the migratory birds. Okay, migration क्या होता है? जब कोई animal या bird उड़कर यहाँ पर चलकर कहीं और चले जाते हैं और ठंड का सीजन या फिर गर्मी का सीजन आते ही वापस अपने पुराने घर पर आ जाते हैं. लीगल प्रोविजन फॉर कंजर्वेशन ऑफ बायोडाइवर्सिटी इन आवर कंट्री. सेवरल लीगल प्रोविजन और एक्ट रिलेटेड टू कंजर्वेशन ऑफ वाइल्ड लाइफ एंड फॉरेस्ट हैव बीन इनेक्टेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट. दीज आर फॉरेस्ट कंजर्वेशन एक्ट एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ प्रोटेक्टेड एक्ट. दिस एक्ट empower government and forest department to create and manage reserve forest, protected forest and village forest, to conserve forest as a natural heritage, to control movement of forest produce, to control the regulate cattle grazing in forest. Wildlife Protection Act. Wildlife Protection Act के अंदर क्या क्या था, objective क्या था, इसके क्या रोकना चाह रहे थे. यह आपका आ गया prohibition of hunting of listed threatened species, setting up and management of national parks, sanctuaries and bioreserves, control and management of captive breeding, protection of species of plants and natural habitat of animals. Okay, bachcho, ye aapka chapter khatam.